Heartbleed itself is related to a vulnerability in an encryption package widely used called Open SSL. And the vulnerability lies in this heartbeat extension. Luckily, a lot of the sites out there, like Facebook and Google, were notified earlier on, prior to public disclosure of the vulnerability. So they were able to clean up their own resources before the vulnerability was made public. The problem with the vulnerability is that it was introduced in this OpenSSL code 2 years ago. So it's been out there that long. And particularly because it's such an unusual exploit to look for, it's very difficult to go back and figure out whether or not a company has been targeted with and exploited or compromised with this Heartbleed exploit. There is a lot of maintenance work that companies have to do. So first off, companies need to know what their assets really are, what sorts of web servers they're running, what version of software they've got, where their certificates are. Companies running these web servers have to understand, are they running Apache or Nginx? And are they running SSL sessions? And most likely, if there is sensitive information being communicated with a visitor, they are using SSL or TLS, really is the vulnerable protocol. More likely than not, they are running the vulnerable version. As a matter of fact, it was estimated that more than half of the resources, the web servers on the internet, were running a version of OpenSSL that was vulnerable in one way or another. Even the companies that were aware early on still left some resources unprotected. So even the guys who know what they've got and know about the vulnerability are taking a lot of time to clean up their own resources. It goes into revoking certificates, removing them from servers, regenerating private keys. There's a lot of web administrative overhead with cleaning up the problem. And then on top of that, you've got to reboot and restart your services. So that potentially could mean quite a bit of downtime for your service. It depends on if you have network load balancing and global caching. If you're more distributed, your customers might not see as much downtime. But if you are not terribly distributed, some of your customers may see some downtime. The fix itself is necessary because there's nothing your customers can do to protect their own information from being stolen off of your servers. This is a problem. The servers themselves that you're running, if they are vulnerable, not only could you lose authentication credentials to your sites, but if a customer retrieves some personally identifiable information from your website, and that remains in memory, an attacker can hit your vulnerable server with the Heartbleed exploits and just start pulling out chunks of memory to read from. And the personally identifiable information that that customer just retrieved from your server can real quickly be grabbed by an attacker. It's very difficult to identify whether or not this has happened, so it's a large and insidious problem. If they were running really old versions of OpenSSL, which they shouldn't be, and then they'd have other vulnerabilities to deal with, then they'd be fine against this particular vulnerability, but then they open themselves up to a whole rash of other problems.